Reach Around Radio, man. We'll reach around, smack your ass, man. ASAP.
Y'all ready to get dirty? Do y'all really want to get X-rated? Bottoms up.
Yo, we are back. New intern night here at Reach Around Radio. It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog, all up in Club Fluffy's for his first time at listening to the show. Club Fluffy's is a club for all the big girls. They get in free till 2:30. We party till 3:35. On and cracking. Tonight in the VIP room, we have Wesley Snipes, because it's New Jack's. We have Wesley Snipes.
Strawberry soda. What
is it's New Jack City. Shout out. Night. Just got out of jail.
Just got out of jail.
Like, I heard Sylvester Stallone gave him a job, though.
Yeah, in the next.
Another movie, right?
In the one, the.
Whatever they did before. Something.
The what?
Expendables, yeah.
And we got drink specials. Our normal drink person is not working the bar today. Portis, would you like to do the bar?
Again.
Sure.
What drink specials do you have for us tonight, Portis?
We have Chambord. Sipped through a vaporizer straw.
Wow. I do that.
Get high and drunk all at the same time.
Hilarious.
TDP's working the coat check room. What we got in the coat check room there?
Hey, too. I got Lucky over here working with me. And she said, find a stump to fit your rump.
Yeah.
And the bakery is cracking. We have all the Chambord.
Yeah, we got Chambord. All the ladies get on the dance floor. It's New Jack City night here at Club Fluffy's. What? All light skins come to life.
Come to life.
Life.
Why is it so low?
Christopher Williams.
Turn your headphones up. Silly.
That's funny. There's like Christopher Williams, and then we mentioned Wesley Snipes.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a debate on which one knocked the shit out of Halle Berry.
Oh.
Everybody thought it was Christopher at first.
I thought it was
Wesley because
no, the baseball player.
Dave Justice. David Justice. It wasn't him.
But okay, Wesley
he got beat up before him.
Yeah,
because she
said that wrong.
She's deaf in one ear.
Yeah, because I thought it was because of Wesley. You.
Yeah, they said it was Wesley Snipes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, he do have little bitch tendencies because he came to Fox House. We playing chess.
Drop.
No, that
was okay.
And I beat him.
That's what happens when you drink beer.
I thought Fox beat him.
No, well, Fox beat him too, but I beat him in chess and he got mad. And Fox
what was he going to do?
Fox
what
like,
did
Speed.
He do?
He was like, the nigga win. I was like, no.
Why?
No. I beat his ass.
I was
supposed to
beat her
him.
Ass. No. Turn it up!
It just let me sleep.
Uh oh.
Don't wake me up till my dream is complete.
Uh oh.
I'm dreaming. Just leave me alone. Unplug the light and unplug the phone.
Was you doing the rock?
Yeah.
For you to say that you would be mine.
Go on, Speedy.
Now that you're here, you're here by my side.
Come on now.
Who's here?
Is that the Roger Rabbit?
Just
or the Troop. What did they call that?
That was the Troop.
The Troop.
Say what, Teeter?
Scoop me more ice cream.
I was doing it then. I had a little word up. I had the hella high top fade.
You had a high top fade.
Larry Blackman.
Couldn't tell me shit. It wasn't like.
Did you have the red cone?
The red cone?
Oh, the cockpit.
What you call it? The cockpit?
Yeah.
What's the cockpit?
You know the red alarm that he wears down by
no,
his.
No, I ain't wearing
it. Talking about the cameo.
Yeah,
waist.
You just got a brake light off a 93 Cadillac.
Hey, how much for this? I got a show tonight.
Oh, my cheeks.
I had a high top fade. And then I had a California curl. I had waves.
You had dreads.
Had locks.
That's when I met you, and you was all mean.
Hilarious.
He was on tour.
Yeah, he was on tour.
I had the ball.
I just wanted Claudia's bitch friends.
Wow, Speedy. That's why you
now
not
he want
a
hit, right?
That's why you're not getting.
I saw the couch.
Out.
I got a hit now.
Ooh,
beautiful couch.
Yeah,
I want to get down there and put my tongue.
You'll love it at Levitt's.
You'll love it at Levitt's.
How old is that commercial?
Yeah,
not even Levitt's around.
So funny.
It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog in the house wearing fresh softball. 14-0-14
We get
shirt.
The jerseys, 2 games left in the season.
Right. A playoff game only.
How many games we got left?
Hilarious.
Oh, five. We got four?
See?
Got four.
We can get in there.
We can get a win.
Still got a chance.
You know your hair match your jersey.
I was like, yeah, Ashley, you got a cellophane? It's looking extra shiny today.
I thought when she put the sweater on, the ink came off or something.
Yeah, I was like,
swinging a miss by Sasha.
I know, where
hey, he's drunk.
Are you all right over there always?
Oh, that beer to kick in.
Oh, we can't do that beforehand? Okay. Okay.
Hilarious. So,
yeah. No sound effects.
No, it's too much. It's extra.
He ain't got enough fingers.
Now he mad.
Portis, did you used to put Kool-Aid in your hair?
I think I might have tried that once.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I didn't like that hair when your grandmother took her hand like this and swing it over. You ever do
like
that?
Your like face,
you
ever swing like it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, get all this shit.
Come in.
I did that to my daughter. She's like, mm-mm. Like, what's
wrong,
Maya?
Ain't putting that stinky thumb on me.
Yeah, that's why somebody invented sanitizer. I'm tired of people somebody licking on me.
Well, you dark, so y'all always show up.
What?
Sleep show up right in the eye.
You got sleep in your eye.
Hilarious.
Always, you ain't never heard nobody say that to you. You light skin, so it blend in. When you teeter color.
But it's green. It's going to show up on everybody. Hilarious.
It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog.
I'm the poetess.
Yes, you are.
Teeter on Twitter.
Nikki Pam.
And where's Claudia?
Colorado on her travel show. Working her travel show. She just got there too.
Work!
On AT&T.
And RT is where?
On tour.
Now, no. RT is at home with a sore throat.
Yeah.
What about Hot Topic?
See.
My man!
What?
I'm in your mix!
Yeah, no more drinking and working for you, motherfucker. Yeah, been doing this shit, what, 2 years?
Yeah.
Pretty much kept it the same way every 2 years.
DJ.
Make sure that's the right shit.
.008.
Hot
air. There she go.
What she got
doing? DJ jumped the gun.
I don't care if her mother is here. It's butt naked. Oh!
Hey, Portis.
Running around the house.
Peace, honey.
Sit down.
With a little bit of legs up. Got a little bit of legs up. Work it all out.
Look at it. Aww.
All out. Monkey.
You like just playing, Mom.
You like that monkey, yeah? I mean, you like the monkey.
Yeah.
Song. Okay.
All right.
What's
speaking
going
on? Speaking of
your mom
couches,
to go outside for a minute.
Uh-huh.
Couches. Wait a minute. Where is that story
It's
at?
Your story.
Your
okay.
Computer.
Police in Wisconsin. Huh? Have accused a 46-year-old man of enjoying curbside sex with a discarded couch.
Man, what you doing on the curb?
Right? Hilarious.
He was eating on the couch?
Through the springs?
Reports say that the off-duty officer was jogging when he spotted Gerald Streeter allegedly doing the deed with the furniture.
Oh my God.
Authorities charged him with one count of lewd and lascivious behavior.
Great. You think?
Great
which
charge.
Carries
I don't
a maximum.
Right that word. I don't
great.
I would have went lewd and lewd stuff.
And things.
And things.
Which carries a maximum of 9 months in prison. According to police report, he had been thrusting his pelvic area
into the pillow
against the cushions and trying to sexually gratify himself by rubbing his penis between the two cushions.
So fill this out. He in jail. Everybody, what you in here for? Murder? What you in here for, dog? Fucking his couch.
No, right?
He was doing what?
You know what? I think I heard Corey Holcomb say something like that before on his show.
Like
humping the couch. I think I
okay. Did it. Is this
Sonny
a normal
is
thing?
Sonny is confirming this story.
He did?
Yes,
now,
I heard
a big
Corey
thing?
Said that
yeah,
he
is this the new thing
okay.
Fucks his couch.
Apparently.
A fetish?
These ain't
okay.
No leather couches. I know that.
Right.
We're all
nice.
Micro suede.
I beat the couch up.
I beat your couch up.
How do you know that's the right couch for you, though? How you just know that's the right one?
I don't don't know. I guess you fill it out.
You got to put a hole in. You can't really do it between the pillows. That ain't.
Let me turn down this street, see what's going on.
Let's go see if I can find me a couch. Yeah.
He probably looked at the police officer and went, hey, runner. Yeah.
Well, get some of this couch.
You go second and get pillow seconds.
Well, anyway.
Now you got 9 months.
Got 9 months.
Explain that to your family on visiting day.
Yeah.
Yeah, your daddy in jail for fucking that couch. Daddy, say it ain't so.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, the next story. Mm-hmm. Woman arrested for performing oral sex in exchange for a discount deal on a Cadillac.
Oh, bless her heart.
Can you give me that number, please? Did she get a real discount?
Well, Crystal was spotted performing oral sex on a 58-year-old man. She's 28. In public,
that's about right.
in exchange for a better deal on a Cadillac she wanted to buy from him. According to reports, dispatchers received complaints of indecent exposure in a parking lot. The act was allegedly allegedly took place in the Cadillac.
You think?
That she wanted to buy.
How much is the Cadillac?
So, ma'am, how much do you want navigation?
You want stick automatic? Can you imagine?
So she's at the car lot.
Yeah. My stick.
She's at the car lot.
Wow.
Wow.
You want 5,000? I don't handle 5,000. What you got? 2,000 and a favor? No, I can't. You can't make a 2,000.
Yes, I can.
Well, let's test drive the car and see what happens.
Pam, is your head game worth that?
What?
A Cadillac.
A Cadillac.
I would think so.
Because
I'm going to say, like,
how much off of 5,000?
So the car cost.
So you're trying to get a Cimarron.
You want a Sedan-deville.
Sedan-deville.
So, Pam, you got $3,500. The car costs $5,000. You got $1,500 worth of...
Can you make up the difference?
I think so.
Is it sloppy? Is it sloppy?
Thanks, Speedy.
Just answer the question.
Answer the question.
Thanks, Speedy.
I'm just going to get punked into answering the question, huh?
Pretty
much. No, I'm just kidding.
Spitting shit coming out.
Nikki, Pam, you ain't never been shy to talk about
sex.
How you get down.
I love it.
Wow.
Why should we be shy? We all do
That's
it, right?
That's right.
We all do it.
Speedy, if she loves it and you can't get it, what's going on?
Because he was mean to me when he had his dreads.
See? Wow. See? First impression.
Anyway, needless to say, the woman was charged with prostitution.
Oh, come on.
She has some money to pay for it.
And the guy was charged for, you know, patronizing a prostitute. And
how was she a prostitute?
How was that a prostitute? Yeah.
Well, I guess for sexual
favor.
Yeah. It had a...
You get plane tickets, you're a prostitute.
Pay. Shut up.
What kind of world we live in when you can't get your dick sucked for a cat like terrible.
Right. For the balance. Consider prostitution. Yeah. For the balance.
Can you do me for the balance?
I'm going to need one more payment out of you, man. That's going to be doing the 19th.
Right,
okay.
Bring it up here.
I'd love to have a car lot like that.
You'd be all broke.
No, I won't.
Her friends be coming up there. I only got $3,500.
Well, I got this nice little vehicle for you.
Let's go see this one over here. I need you to stand behind here. Put this thing
in your
mouth.
I would think you would do something like that. You would be that kind of salesperson.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He would.
Because I have a car in the corner with no tires, no windows. Every time you give me some, I'll put an item on the car.
You just got your hubcaps.
Yeah. Do it in my car right there.
I got 4 more installments.
Oh my God.
Put that motor in later.
P, I know people are here, but you ain't never really did something for something.
We're not gonna go into that with my mama sitting right there.
Oh, come on.
Anyway, next story.
Lucky, you know a story.
Anything you wanna tell?
No.
Where was this one time that Felicia
slept with that boy Craig and gave him my good Scooby-Doo cup?
Anyway.
She was over here cracking up.
I used to drink out that.
To the kids. Woman arrested after dispute over missing dildo.
Wow.
Hey, bitch.
Speedy, you seen my...
Speedy.
I'm going to ask you one more time.
Oh, that thing? I made omelets with that.
That was a spatula.
Oh, yeah, the big
spatula. Yeah.
A dispute over a misplaced sex toy ended with arrest.
Oh, come on.
Police in Rock Hill, South Carolina, responded to a domestic violence disturbance at a home of Artisha.
Guess what race?
Yeah. I'm gonna
go. Right. And her girlfriend, LaToya.
Yeah. Duh. Definitely black.
Hudson, well, LaToya told police that Artisha, began looking for her detachable latex penis.
Wow.
What?
Detachable. And became upset when she could not find it.
Detachable.
Yes. Argue.
Latex.
His wife.
Like a strap on.
Wait, wait, wait. Oh, okay, okay. Yeah.
Yes, strap on.
Okay, we was like, what?
Okay.
Well, when she couldn't find it, she got highly upset, threw an ironing board at her girlfriend.
Oh, she
called
must be
police.
She a dude.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I ain't never thought about throwing an ironing board. You know how heavy an ironing board is?
It depends what
and
kind.
It might unfold. Wow.
Bitch, earn some. Come on.
You don't want to throw the motherfucker in and unfold.
Wow.
Well, needless to say, God, she was charged with misdemeanor, assault, and battery.
For her dildo.
Detachable.
Right. And that's not the only story. There was another story about a couple between... Wait, sex toys become... Okay. In 2001, a Florida man was arrested for allegedly beating his girlfriend after she woke him up with a sex toy.
Oh, damn.
Wow.
Why'd you quit playing with me like that? No, y'all get stupid and be like, you know you like it. No.
No, I think she was probably using it on herself, and the fact that she just got, that she woke him up.
No,
is what I think.
I think she put
she
it
probably
because she
used it on him.
It doesn't tell
do
what happened.
I'm pretty sure.
But she probably was playing with it on his face.
He was
up.
Like, bitch.
That's why I had to figure out as I got older why we couldn't go in your parents' room.
Because your
parents had that little box in there.
Yeah.
I always wonder why my mother would be like, get out the fucking room. I said, Mom, just get in the purse. Get the fuck out of my room.
Me too. I found my mom's.
She had a box?
Dildo, I sure did.
What?
And
then
she had company over and I didn't know what it was. And I came out there, picked it up. I said, Mom, what is this? In front of her company.
She said, oh my God.
Ooh, she cussed me out.
She said, a popsicle.
Remember now go days, put it in your mouth.
Like in days when it rained hard and the water going down the street, we took a box of tampons that was put in boat racing down the street.
Boy, if you don't get them damn things out the street.
They didn't know what they were.
The popsicle sticks, we never used the.
Nah, because you know you get a popsicle stick, but then you're always trying to faster, lighter boat.
Right.
Tampons is fast.
Yeah, until they get water in it.
You can't take them out the package. You got a dead boat right there.
Oh my gosh.
Why your boat swelling up?
Yeah. We made a little dam in the street. Very absorbent.
Oh my God.
I told you one thing about the tampon.
What? You use what?
You got wings.
So, my mama left the box in the bath because they usually put it right behind the toilet. So I see the box and it had the instructions.
Mm-hmm.
So, I didn't know it had the little lady had her leg up. I said, this me. This gonna be my little hookup, right? I kept it was in my pocket for like
this nigga.
Oh, you took the direction.
He masturbated.
Yeah, the seventh grade to eighth grade. That was in my back.
Oh, that was your first porn.
Hilarious.
Oh my God.
It was a drawing, and they showed a little lip.
A little drawing with the leg.
Yeah, yeah. They got her leg up on the thing.
That turned you on.
Hey.
Hysterical.
In the seventh grade, I was on a dirt bike. That's
it was an illustration. It wasn't even a picture.
Right.
For me, that was the one.
And you was on your dirt bike? Yeah, I can't wait to get to the corner and read it again.
Sit on that couch.
Move over.
Well, speaking of masturbation, Elijah Slocum.
Isaiah.
He's here.
Isaiah.
is accused of fervently masturbating on the beach.
She got the words today, right?
What is
fervently?
Like,
fervently.
Excessively.
Like, super, like
a lot.
Yeah.
Like, you trying to pop the head off?
Yeah, like, aggressively, I guess. I don't know.
A witness told police that the man had his penis in his hand and was making up and down motions indicating masturbation. Yeah, according to police, during Slocum's date with
date night.
Amala, his whole body was shaking. Like
oh, so he had just hit that point.
I got sand in my eyes. I can't see, but I can't stop.
They're going to police. So what?
He was shaking fervently. Like convulsions. Like
on the beach?
On the beach, wow. In front of everybody.
They're like, hey, we can't do nothing for him.
Mouth to mouth.
No.
Excuse me, is this spot taken?
Needless to say, Slocum was arrested and accused of intentionally masturbating and exposing his genitals in a lewd and lascivious exhibition.
Wow.
I want to let ladies know who work out. Get gloves. Men don't want you with the motherfucking rough palms. Can I do you? No, not with all that. Because when you work out, you're talking about lifting
weight. Oh, okay.
And you calluses. Calluses on your hand.
I don't have calluses.
Yeah, your hands are very soft.
I know.
Porter's hands are.
Yeah. Well, I don't wash dishes without
gloves.
You've
never touched my hands. What are you talking about?
I've touched more than your hands.
Like what else, Speedy?
Your mama's here. You wanted to know?
Yeah, why don't you? Oh, yeah, that's right.
Team R.A.R.
That was a half.
You did touch a breast. Boob.
Yeah.
Wow.
She said, oh, I know. Mom said she knew about that too, Speedy.
Birthday.
She said she saw it.
Mm. I don't think my dad appreciated it.
Yeah, well, yeah. You pregnant now. We got a little Speedy Felicia coming along. A DJ comic.
Mom said, I don't think so.
Man steals father's dead body from funeral home and keeps it in a deep freezer in hopes that it will come back to life.
Wow.
Wow.
Well, why keep it in the freezer?
Hey.
Put a coat on him.
Well, didn't Walt Disney freeze himself?
I
thought he froze
he
his head, though. Didn't he freeze his head?
I think they froze his
body. I thought it was the whole thing.
Yeah.
Was it ain't that the cryogenics or something
cryogenics.
Like that?
Yeah, that's it.
But he didn't have cryogenics. He put them in his freezer.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. How you?
Yeah.
He was next to
turning on 9 and
well, they say that
move these waffles over.
Daddy, gotta get some ice cubes. Don't go in there. Grandpa here.
Well, they say that he was charged with disentering a body.
Disentering.
Yeah, I guess that's digging a body up. Disentering.
Oh, he didn't go to the.
He's at the site already.
He was at the funeral home.
Oh, okay.
So was
it's a crime punishable up to 10 years in prison.
Ooh,
so. Wow!
Dang,
taking your daddy home. It's my daddy.
So at the funeral, or he waited till everybody left.
That's crazy. He broke in at the wake in the middle night or whatever. But wow.
And we would show y'all the body, but it ain't here.
Does anybody here sleepwalk?
Mm-mm. Black people don't sleepwalk. You go to jail when you sleepwalk. If you're black,
you go to jail. Yeah, that's not right.
Leslie Cusack.
See what I tell you.
Allegedly keeps herself on a slim diet during the day because at night she sleepwalks and eats and cooks and wakes up in the morning and sees all these empty containers of food and dishes.
Oh, wow. She gorgeous.
Yeah, she's greedy.
She greedy.
I sleepwalk.
I bet if she didn't buy no groceries, she wouldn't sleepwalk.
Exactly.
Right.
Or sleep be like, bitch, ain't no food in here.
But you know what? I've woken up in the middle of the night in a sleepy haze.
What did you have on there? Slow the music down, please.
In a sleepy haze, it made like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich or something.
But you didn't, you weren't aware?
I was aware, but I was still half sleepy.
Did you lick the knife?
Was it a butter knife?
Yeah.
Did you?
Oh, gosh.
Do tell.
Was it peanut?
Did you put your slippers on or you just went right in the kitchen?
I just went right in the kitchen. Oh,
did you have that top on?
In the middle
on?
Of the night. Just
so bitties are just bouncing all over?
Basing. They was basing.
So you're a white or a wheat bread girl?
Speedy is a
did
damn
take a
mess.
Spoonful
He's a
of
freak.
Mayonnaise? Did you do a spoonful of mayonnaise? Hey, did you do the jelly, though? What kind of jelly?
He said peanut butter jelly.
Oh, yeah.
Strawberry preserves.
Yeah.
But did you have nuts in your peanut butter? Do you want nuts?
Okay. Never mind.
Hey, make me one while you in there.
Girl, you ain't sleepwalking. You high.
Right.
One more story.
You woke up in a haze like it was foggy.
Purple what? Haze.
Do you remember that though?
Yeah, I remember it because I when I wake up full. In the morning, I taste peanut butter in my mouth.
Oh, who gave me a sip?
I hope it don't mix with my mayonnaise.
Oh, God.
Who put nuts in this?
When I come in that kitchen, nobody that better be in there.
That's funny. I see two brains. It's somebody in this motherfucker.
Police, hello? Yeah, somebody made a sandwich at my house.
You sitting over forensics?
Yeah. Somebody made a sandwich at my house.
I want a dust for print.
So man. None of y'all have never done that?
No.
So look, police show up. So what happened, ma'am? I was asleep. And then the haze happened, and the motherfucker made two sandwiches. As you can see here, see the bite marks? My teeth are not shaped like that. At least not when I'm asleep.
Because I like milk with mine.
Now this mayonnaise spoon is mine. Because I had
you
a
know,
cough.
Yeah, I'm sick, you know.
I need white shit in my mouth.
So, Speedy, you don't wake up in the middle of the
night. Trust me, I'm wide awake when I get up. I go through the cabinets like this. Let me see.
Speedy has a refrigerator Spam. By his bed, so he doesn't have to.
Oh, my God.
Don't you, Speedy. You have a refrigerator in your room?
With the glass front. It's right in there. I see it.
Open.
Oh, my gosh. I'm tired of laughing.
You ever get it while you sleep? We ain't really sleep, but you know, I play along with you.
Anyway.
Yeah, move your leg out the
way. Last story.
That's the best, though, Speedy. I ain't gonna lie.
Take your underwear
you
off.
You be trying to play it off like.
Why'd your mama
okay.
shake her head?
Okay.
Your mama shook her head.
Going to roll over on that sandwich, baby.
Watch out for the mayonnaise. You gonna lay in the mayonnaise.
You gonna just gonna ignore Nikki Pam?
She I'm said sorry.
What did I say?
She said it's the best.
Oh yeah, that's the best sex. Yeah,
because you ain't really sleeping.
He ain't listening.
Yeah, because you faking the funk.
Yeah,
for real. You
like dudes that take their underwear off but keep their eyes closed because you don't want to mess the game.
Yeah, because you don't want to catch eyes. Yeah, you don't want
to
catch eyes.
You gotta know how to take them off and kick them with your toes.
Don't you ever get a Charlie horse trying to do that?
Oh, yeah.
You gotta wake up out that crap.
That's why I don't do little young girls, because you say cramp, you're like, cramp? What's wrong with you?
I'm old, bitch.
Pam, if I say cramp, she go get a hot towel.
Right.
A banana, some Gatorade. Rub the back of my leg. Telling them when the cramp go away, we go and get in there again.
That's so true.
You don't never do it with the window open, though, Teeter. When you over 50, close all your windows. Turn the fan off. Nigga, you a good one.
Can't have no breeze.
You can't breeze at 50. And then most dudes won't say shit. We keep trying to go, and the girl be like, what's wrong with you? Nothing, bitches.
It's a new style.
It's called the one-legged stretch.
Don't feel me cramping up in you.
Your man ain't never had a cramp?
Yeah.
What'd you do?
Left.
You know she cussed him out. You know she cussed him out.
Right. Getting a damn cramp.
What you put your Timberlands on then?
Oh, man. This next story.
What you got, P?
This man saved a McDonald's hamburger for 14 years and it still looked the same.
That's disgusting.
I don't believe that.
It didn't have any fungus.
I don't believe
what?
It would have had fungus.
Preserved it how, though? He had to preserve it.
Unless he preserved it next to his
dad.
He said
it was in the same bag that he bought. He said originally he saved it for like 2 months to show people that
that's scary.
The food does not rot, mold? That the preservatives are...
Okay.
So how'd he get to 14?
I guess he kept it. And then 2 years went by, and it was still the same, and so he just kept it.
Now, what kind of burger?
The article says 14 years.
Was this a Big Mac?
Was it Big Mac?
Or a McDowell burger?
It just said a cheeseburger.
Oh, okay. So,
well, damn.
Well, cheeseburger ain't got nothing on it but two pickles.
They said the pickles actually disintegrated.
Oh, it did?
Yeah, they turned into relish.
But the hamburger... But no, if you look at it, I think...
No, I don't believe it.
14 years, though?
You ain't... Do you have anything in your house over 5 years you kept long?
Well, yeah.
Not no food item.
No, I'm just saying in general. No.
Yeah.
So why would he keep food for 14 years?
As an experiment.
Right.
This nigga working Taco Bell.
Well, he said that he... decided to keep the burger for even longer to see how long it could continue looking normal.
Right.
And it, Mr. Whipple was on the show, Hilarious. The Doctors. You remember, you know yeah. that show, The mm-hmm. Doctors? Uh-huh. And he said he was showing some people how enzymes work, and he thought the burger would be a good idea. Mm. So he had just left it, and I guess occasionally checked on it. And he had one time left tried to sell open. It on eBay.
Hilarious. Oh my God!
Somebody bid it up to $2,000 for it.
He didn't sell it?
Wow! No, he didn't.
No, he kept it.
Oh, he didn't sell it?
But he said it was no signs of mold, fungus, or even a strange odor.
Wow!
I don't even know what to say about that. That's scary.
14-year-old burger from McDonald's.
Just a cheeseburger.
I know one thing, them fries. You.
This is a burger, not a cheeseburger. I know something happened to the cheese.
Yeah, the cheese would have to have molded.
I don't know if he had cheese on
That's
it.
That's what I'm saying. It was a burger to burger.
Like you said, just some pickles.
Probably a regular burger.
A little mustard mayo and call it a day.
He ordered a cheeseburger with no cheese.
Cheese, no cheese.
No cheese.
No cheese on
yeah.
that.
Right on that. And that's like that's crazy, though.
Yeah.
And that's it for
Hot Topics.
With your little bitty legs up.
Mm. Monkey up. We go right into seconds.
I know. I was like, damn, no break.
Ladies and gentlemen. Lend me your ears. Yeah, he's been drinking.
I'm like, what?
Not yet. I said during the party. But...
Shout out to rehearsal.
Yeah. Tita Sports Ticket right here on Reach Around Radio. Let's just get right into it. NFL draft. First overall pick, Eric Fisher, offensive tackle for Michigan, was the number one pick in the draft. So they're getting
Top,
back to the
first four picks, three were linemen.
Yeah, offensive linemen, because you have to protect the quarterback because they're getting big deals right now. So yeah. All these defensive schemes, you have to have somebody to protect the quarterback's blind side. So that's what that offensive tackle position is. Because in the NFL, Aaron Rodgers just signed a 5-year, $110 million deal. Guaranteed $62
million. Damn. Up front.
A record. Yes.
Gonna take that
a record
gonna for take that to the
signing bonus. Yes. And New York Jets dropped off Tim Tebow.
Yeah.
So Tim Tebow is looking for a situation. I think he could
be
a quarterback.
Come on up here
to
Reach Around Radio.
Canada.
We need somebody on our baseball team.
Oh, is that right? Okay. And NBA news. It's going down. These playoffs have been very exciting. Those Knicks are 3-1 over those Celtics, avoiding the sweep. Miami Heat sweep Milwaukee.
Yes, my team.
Jennings promised that they would win and guarantee game in six games. And
no, somebody Twitter and said what he really meant was that number six was going to beat him.
Right. And those Spurs sweep those Los Angeles Lakers.
Oh, my God.
We're out of there.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Twitter was going in on Dwight.
Yeah, it was crazy.
He's soft.
It was ugly.
He is.
It was just an ugly game in general because they're two both slow teams. So it's like.
Here's the question for you, Teeter and Pam.
Mm-hmm.
Your GMs, do you pay dude that money?
No.
Teeter. Yeah.
Who? You pay who?
Dwight.
Dwight.
Hell no.
Because if he goes somewhere else.
Bye.
We don't have a chance to do nothing with them, so we might as well keep them here. We just signed a $3 billion TV deal, so that's
a luxury tax right
80
now.
Million, 80 million, yes. Mil. But $3 billion versus 80 million, we don't have a problem with that.
But you lose them. They don't play well together.
Well, it's not that they don't play well together.
And Steve is going to be 40 next year.
Okay, we understand all that, Speedy. But
he's 40.
But how old is Fish? Even if he was there, he'd be about
Fish
the same.
Was 30, but Fish is nice. He saw him hit them jumpers the other night.
Mm. Yeah, that's true.
White dudes age like bananas.
Yeah.
That's wrong.
They do.
But if we can get Bynum back, if he's healthy, because he doesn't want to play in Philadelphia.
Oh, he doesn't?
That'd be a great thing. So
y'all would take Bynum back?
Yeah.
I would.
We won with him.
Big natural and all.
We won with him. He don't want to play there. He want to play with us. And those Bulls. Over those Nets 3-1. How about those Golden State Warriors? Mark Jackson is doing an excellent job.
Did you see his wife sing national anthem?
Darlene, Miss Coleman.
Oh, please tell me what happened.
She went a little bit.
The national anthem is geared to a certain amount of time, but she put a remix on the end. Uh-huh. That
Yeah.
Buzz
bursting all up in the air.
Please show your love for Desiree Coleman. And I said the home and the home.
I said other. What y'all want to call her? The brain.
It was thunder over the rocket.
She was on fire, though. And, shout out to her. I know her very well. She was very good.
Yes.
I got her
can she sing?
Yes. Oh, yeah. She can
sing. She's got a gospel album?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's she's known for gospel. You know,
thunder over the rockets.
Desiree.
Hilarious.
Mark Jackson is a preacher.
I didn't know that. Yeah, really?
Yeah, when he ended the game, he on the pulpit.
Can you text her on this?
Oh, sorry.
Thunder over the Rockets, 3-0. No Russell Westbrook with a messed up knee.
Yeah, they whooping ass right now, too.
So he'll be out for, I wouldn't say the rest of the playoffs.
I'm going to say so. Because you saw what happened when Meta came back. He wasn't the same.
Yeah, you're never the same. But yeah,
he's going past
but it's
Meta.
Their year to get in there to get it done. Because if not, the Spurs has a nice little cakewalk.
Yeah.
Going through.
Or the Clippers.
Or Golden State. It's going to be exciting. The second round is going to be very exciting.
You know, I love your segment because Poetess always act like she don't even know what's going on. She looks at us and goes,
here you go then, Poetess News. UFC 159, John Jones versus Sun.
Whatever his name is.
Yeah, light heavyweight championship. First round, 4:33 in.
He broke his toe. Didn't know it until he was standing up. He looked down. He went, shit.
Yeah, this is his fifth straight defense of his title. Tied with Tito Ortiz from Huntington Beach. He broke his toe.
He's a very humble guy. That's what I like.
Yeah, he's a great fighter.
The elbows ain't no joke.
He used that guy's style.
But I knew he was going to lose, the white dude, because when they had him on ESPN, he was, you know how they ask you shit like, what are you going to do in a fight? Well, I'm going to get in there and I'm going to do some things. And they was like, no, seriously, what are you going to do? And he kept joking around.
The interview was longer than the fight.
Yeah, he was. Exactly.
And in track and field, Penn Relays, that's in Pennsylvania. Philadelphia, the Penn Relays, please, world famous all over the world. Jamaican girls, 4x100 women's relay, Jamaica girls, you know.
You know why I watched it? I'm going to just be real with you, Teeter. And P, you can get in on this. The reason I watched the track and field, because them girls' bodies,
yeah,
man, they don't look that good. They're a little strong in the face, but they bodies.
Be on point.
Yeah. No Kamala to Jeter Lee. Ooh. And Sonya Richards Ross. They were out of the race, and they raced with the girls. And the Team Jamaica, them girls look good. That one girl in the anchor leg, her legs look like, my goodness.
They got them Poetess legs.
Yeah. Them Robert Newhouse thighs. Right. And that's been Teeter Sports Ticker. Yes, Poetess.
Congratulations to Michael Jordan.
He got married.
He dividing his money up again.
They said that his wedding tent was the hugest wedding tent ever. It was bigger than his 350 square foot home.
Yeah, it was on a golf course.
Shut up, really?
Yeah.
Yes, and I guess he made sure the paparazzi wasn't.
Oh, he has over like 4,000 or 5,000 people now.
You know? Yeah. Oh my God.
Yes.
Yeah, so
he married the model. What's her name? Petro
or
now
Pietro,
she real
like that. Yeah. Like that.
You not gonna talk about?
I know, but his previous marriage, he had the biggest divorce settlement in history at one point.
200 million.
Yeah. So she got a grip.
She got more than what's her name? The white girl.
I don't think she got more than Tiger's.
Yeah, that's what
you know the
Tiger's
story behind that, right?
What's that?
So after they made the settlement and everything, and they was in court, you know, Michael got his paper with it. Like, okay, it was like $200 million. He wrote her a check for $150 million in court, and handed it to her and said, "I'm not even gonna miss that."
Wow.
Gangsta.
I can't even write a $150 check. I'd be like, bitch, can I have that back, please?
You gotta follow me to the ATM.
And your boy came out today.
Who's your boy?
Jason Collins.
Yeah, he came out today.
He's the first American athlete to come out in a major sport while playing the game.
Yep.
He's one of a twin.
Speedy.
Stanford University.
Gonna sing the lyrics.
So this is official coming out day? What's today's date?
I don't know.
And did someone else come out today as well?
Speedy.
I thought an NFL player came out.
No.
Oh, no, that's
no.
That's in Nikki Pam's scrambled eggs. And
hilarious.
Hey, if he's gay, so I don't know why people make such a big issue. If they're gay, who cares?
Right.
I don't know why.
Too bad we don't live in a world.
Don't get me wrong though. If you playing ball, you don't want no dude behind you D'ing you up with his dick all on your back.
Right.
And you like my man. Play me on the side. But
what about all the ass slapping and shit? Right. That y'all showering do on the naked. Court?
No. It's only if he slap your ass. You're like, hey, I didn't even shoot.
Hey, Jason, who you?
So y'all don't feel no kind of way when a guy slaps your ass on the court?
I'm just being real. You like it, Tita?
You don't slap the ass. You just slap on the side of the back, or you don't slap on the actual ass.
I've seen ass.
Stand up, Sonny.
I know. I've seen Chris Bosh do it.
Show me on Sonny.
Why is he bending over? Stand up like a man.
No, I ain't never liked it.
Hilarious.
Never liked it.
No, you don't ever slap on the ass. You slap on the
So, side. If somebody... in the group, like one of your boys came out, Speedy, would you look at him differently?
Why did you?
Yeah, exactly.
Always. She looked at always.
Do you have an exclusive?
You did look at always.
She sure did. She said,
if one of your boys in the group, no, always.
If one of your boys in the group, there happens to be a DJ.
Hey, Speedy, I was just wondering if you want to go pick some flowers today.
Okay, finish your comment, Nikki Perry.
No, that was it. I just want to know if Speedy would.
Yeah, I was. You know what? I was actually thinking that question last week. If somebody in the crew, no females,
right,
came out.
Hilarious. No females, huh? Exclude y'all.
Because y'all don't care about lesbians.
Right.
No, we don't. We just want to watch.
I just want to be with her. I care about her.
So if a dude in our crew came out, would y'all be still cool with him the same way?
Yeah.
Nah.
Peter, stop lying, Speedy. Mm.
I would be. What?
But you would have jokes.
So you
I
wouldn't
know.
Like always I anymore.
I had jokes. No,
I'm
though.
Just kidding. What?
I think if you can take a dick, you can take a joke.
Oh. Yeah,
dick is a lot more harder. These jokes would dissolve sooner or later.
Sooner or later.
It wouldn't matter to me.
Me,
you're a girl.
Yeah, you're a girl. But no, it wouldn't matter. But I will say, if in the shower, all that, you'd be like, well, man.
Right.
Let us know when you want to go, because you know, and he's in there, Peter gazing.
So you wouldn't room with? Would you room with him? Like if we do the?
If we went on a road trip. Y'all couldn't be roommates.
I'd be sleeping with my eyes and a peanut butter sandwich.
Eyes wide shut.
I'll be like, look, anything move. Hey, where you going? No. Oh, you got your clothes off. What's happening?
Nah, Speedy be in the road 3:30 in the morning. So about, you ain't gonna make a move yet.
He didn't even touch me.
Right. My feelings was hurt.
Am I not cute?
Am I not cute?
I'm not cute enough. I thought about that with Luther. Luther's song. You go the whole time he's singing to a dude.
See, early on, we really didn't know. We suspected.
We did.
Especially with Freddie Jackson, I definitely knew. I knew with Freddie.
No, I didn't know with Freddie.
I did. Mm.
But you listen to the songs, you go, wow, he was singing, a house is not a home unless a dude is in it.
That's what you got out of it?
That's what I got out of it.
Oh, my goodness.
Hilarious.
But I knew it when I went to his concert, and I went, oh, he gay.
He said, oh.
He gay. You gay.
Hey, that's a jam, Nada.
For me, what's funny about it, like, if somebody asked me, do I like Luther, I will always say no. But when I hear his music, it's like, man, that dude is incredible. Yeah, it's like crazy.
I actually had a chance to interview Luther once.
Talk about
it. Oh, wow.
And he was so cool and so funny. I was a little nervous, and he... This was, I think I was in New York or something. It was somewhere in some office building. Mm-hmm. And he was just so cool and so funny. So,
no diva, nothing.
Nah,
really?
He was really, really cool. So I was glad to even have the opportunity.
At the BET Awards, he cussed out everybody. Because he was on the diva thing. Uh-huh. So his earpiece wasn't working. And he was behind the curtain. He was like, that's why I don't work at these motherfucking black ass shows, because you motherfuckers. And he went 51-50. And that curtain came up and he started singing. I was like, oh, this. He said, oh.
That's what Invogue said, too. When they, remember they opened up for him on that one tour? Invogue was like, I think they quit the tour.
No,
actually.
He kicked them off.
Okay.
Yeah, they kicked them off. Right.
Didn't he have that same situation with Anita Baker?
Anita too, yep.
And him and Anita got
into
it.
Only room for two bitches on this one.
Right.
Come on, Speedy, let's go.
Now, I did do a show with your boy. What's who? His, who they say is
He man. Gave you that second
No, not Freddie.
Which boy?
The young kid.
Freddie hit on Speedy.
Yeah.
He did?
At the bakery.
No. What happened? I'm in New York City. Uh-huh. I'm doing a play on Broadway. Yes, I was doing a play.
Is it Greenwich Village? Huh.
And at the Beacon. So I'm walking past the little bakery and I see Freddie Jackson in the bakery.
Uh-huh.
And I'm walking and going, I said, damn, I should go back and invite him to the play. That would be dope. Freddie, one of my, Freddie.
Uh-huh.
So I'm at the light and someone said, turn around. And I turn around and Freddie was looking out the bakery like,
you got a hole in the back of your vest. I know, thank you.
I can fix it. No, it's okay.
You gotta trust me.
So when I turn around, I'm like, really? And he was like really staring. I'm like, fuck.
Mm.
So you asked him for a date?
No, I walked on across the street. I'm like, nah, he don't need to come to the play.
So when you cross the street, you realize it was your boy shorts turning them on.
Look at this face.
I gotta take these things off.
Oh, hey. Wow.
No, what's the young kid's name?
Because I don't know who you're talking about.
Starts with a J. Jaheim.
Oh,
so
okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm doing a show in Oakland, and Jaheim is on the show. So I heard about, they say Jaheim. I'm like, nah, I can't be.
Mm-hmm.
He had 15 of the most suspect friends backstage. I was like,
like
every single one of them was like, how you doing? Are you the comedian? I'm like, yeah.
Found number 16.
There's a whole lot of Timmys and Terrells and Stevens. So I'm like, and you don't want to believe it, but every single one of them was suspect. Mm-hmm. Not one, every single one of them was.
See that, don't you think that's a telltale sign?
Oh, if your boys.
If your crew is yeah, come on.
Now.
Hello.
Tell this, I don't care if he find out, I don't care. The guy that plays the on Monique's old show.
Oh, everybody knew that.
I didn't know that. Dorian.
Dorian, yeah.
Isn't Dorian cool? I see Dorian everywhere, and he works out at the gym I work at, but he always got this little petite dude with him at all times. I'm like, hey, whatever, it's a little friend.
Right.
A little friend.
So I do the Black Ski Weekend in Denver, and he was there with this light-skinned dude that had the little waistline sweater on. So I said, give it up for Dorian Wilson.
He had on a halter top?
It looked like it. And I said, who you here with? He said, him. I went...
Him and him.
I literally froze, sure, and I went. Froze. I froze and went. You came out here. Okay, cool.
Oh, it's the same guy from the gym?
No, it was another little light skinned dude. Looked like.
Always. Oh. Always. Scared to say it.
Uncle. But he had a waistline sweater. Like the sweater, you can see his belt buckle.
Oh, okay.
And so I said, where do you get that little sweater at, homie? So everybody's dying laughing. And I keep looking at the dude, and you could tell he was, because he was one of them pritzy little. Uh-huh. He's like, you were so funny.
No. He's like,
I don't know why they always come up to me and tell me I'm funny. How you talking?
Because they're gay.
They've heard stories.
I didn't know that Patti LaBelle shows all the transvestites show up.
Oh please!
Oh, yeah.
That's who they aspire
that's
to
given.
Be.
I didn't know that. So I'm gonna be selling movie business. So I do her show in Oakland at the Paramount.
Mm-hmm.
And I get off. I'm looking at the audience. I see the first two rows is dudes, and they all got flowers in their hand. So I'm like, fuck, I ain't going to sell no DVDs. So I go out in the lobby, and this dude was my...
It was all lined up, huh, Speedy?
This dude was like 6'6", 6'5". He's like, how you doing?
All I want to do is zoom, 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 zoom.
And he had these money rings. And they're all fanned out, and they're all $100 bills.
Mm-hmm.
All fanned out on each finger.
I got one just for you.
You sure remember this story.
How many DVDs you want to say?
I have more back in my hotel room.
That's when I found out. And then my boy was like, yeah, they come to her show like the same dudes.
Hey.
Right.
First two rows, dudes.
Traveled.
Yeah. She's real diva.
Patti LaBelle.
You never had a girl? I know you had girl rappers hit on you.
One did.
Uh-oh.
Really?
Yeah.
Who?
Uh-oh.
I'm not
going
to say her name.
I knew she
but she's not that famous.
Big. What can we just say? Who?
No.
I'm dying to know.
Nah, because she's my homegirl.
I mean, did she really go in like, yo, what's that?
Yeah, I had to really check her. I had to push her.
Oh, you tell me
that
story.
Her. Off of
in the room?
Oh, shit.
No, we were at a bar.
By DJ booth.
Yeah. Hey, put my needle down.
Did she, like,
no,
grab you?
Cool.
She grope you?
She actually snatched me up by my collar.
Wow.
Damn.
And said, don't resist.
in the DJ booth?
And I fucking pushed her hard in her two titties. Boop!
Oh.
And she never had the problem again.
Show me how you did.
I was ready.
I was going to show you how to tell.
No. So,
Pam, you ever had a...
After that, she...
Lesbians love me. I don't know what it is.
You're easy.
Get that bitch some crack.
I mean, like, they get at you, like, aggressive.
Where were we at when we was at the... Oh, no, remember story. We were at the Cork?
Yes.
In the Cork? And remember the waitress came up and just said, here, this drink is for you. And Speedy was like, oh, shit, she want... It was just random, right? I didn't talk to her nothing. She just came and gave me a drink.
Sure did.
Oh, that little cutie one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, the little yellow one.
She hit me and went, excuse me, you want a drink?
I know. Put Speedy all out the way.
Yeah? Tito, you had no dudes get at you?
Nah, Speedy, I don't...
You ain't gonna talk about it?
I don't be around them situations.
Situations.
How about like you that. Always? Another DJ get at you?
Look how he's doing his finger.
Not tonight,
with
bitch.
The pinky up.
Call in,
anyway,
y'all.
It's Reach Around Radio. The phone lines are open. Hit us up 323-965-1600. We're going to jump in the mix with DJ Always, yeah, always in your ear on Twitter.
Yeah, call in. Let us know if somebody got at you from the other sex.
Get it.
Hey, are you tired of those same old energy drinks with bad taste? Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products. For more information on Pitbull Energy Drinks, bars, and mixes, visit their website at hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com. Online orders available at hiphopbev.com.